Hello everybody, you are welcome to this channel. I am Atanu Betal and in this video lecture we discuss about optical isomerism, optical activity of the organic molecules, optically active compound and enantiomers. So this is the topic of discussions right in this video, and before starting the discussions regarding this topic I would like to remind you that if you are new to this channel or you do not subscribe this channel, then you can subscribe this channel right now. Regarding this discussions, optical isomerisms, we have to know that for organic molecules, organic compounds shows isomerism, means compounds that have the similar chemical formula but you know different structures, different spatial arrangements. So these are called isomers, and isomers is isomerism is or in organic chemistry is broadly divided into two classes. One is the stereoisomerism, another is structural isomerism. The optical isomerism is one kind of stereoisomerism, and it is configurational isomerism. So in optical isomerism you can find the that organic molecules, some organic molecules shows optical activity, means they can turn the plane of polarized light either right or left. If they turn the plane of polarized light in right direction, then we call as the dextrorotatory, and if the organic compounds can turn the plane of polarized light in the left side direction, then we call it L or levorotatory, or in modern term D is now designed as plus and L is now designed as minus. Okay, so in class of optical isomerism for organic compounds, the compound should have the optical activity, means compound should be optically active compound. Okay, and what are the conditions required to be an optically active compound? So for organic molecule to be optically active, the main condition is compound, in compound a carbon must be attached to it four different groups of atoms, and this carbon is considered as the chiral carbon, which is defined by a star carbon here, star in the carbon. So when the carbon of a molecule, one central carbon of a molecule is attached with the four different groups of atom or four different types of atom, that time this center is called the chiral center, and the compound is called optically active molecule because of the presence of optically chiral carbon. So compounds that can turn the plane of polarized light either right or left side, we call the compound as optically active compound, and that compound can show the optical isomerism. And for this case of lactic acid, this is called lactic acid, and for this case of lactic acid, this is the structure of lactic acid, and this is the mirror image structure of the lactic acid. As the lactic acid is do not form the superimposable mirror image relationship with its image, so for the lactic acid there are enantiomers possible. These two structures are called enantiomers of lactic acid. One is D and another is L, or in modern term you can say plus and minus. Okay, plus and minus, or D on L enantiomers. L means minus and D means plus. Okay, so a D and L is experimentally determined factor. We cannot say theoretically this is D or this is L conformation. So for this type of molecule where a chiral carbon is present, and due to this presence of this chiral carbon atom, the compound can show the rotation of the plane of polarized light, or compound can turn the direction of the plane of polarized light, and the compound is called optically active compound. So for the case of lactic acid, it is optically active compound, and the mirror image it forms a non-superimposable mirror image relationship with its own, and this is why it is called enantiomers. These two forms are called enantiomers, and enantiomers are named as D enantiomer and L enantiomer, or plus enantiomer and minus enantiomer. So this is the case of lactic acid, and if the molecule have more than one chiral carbon. Chiral carbon means the carbon that is attached with the four different groups of atoms or different types, different atoms. So for the molecule that have the more than one chiral carbon, for example the meso tartaric acid, here you can find the two chiral carbon, because carbon joined with other four groups of atoms or atom. So for this time the two chiral carbon atoms are present, and the molecule is optically meso compound, optically inactive, but two chiral carbons are present. Here two part means upper part and lower part, two carbon atoms present, chiral carbons are present. So the upper part is optically active, lower part is optically active, but the molecule overall has no optical activity. Okay, it is not necessary that the molecule contain chiral carbon, means molecule must be optically active. There are some examples of molecule where molecule does not contain any chiral, molecule have chiral carbons but the molecule is optically inactive. So for this case of the meso tartaric acid molecule, the upper carbon and lower carbon of this tartaric acid is chiral, but it is containing a plane of symmetry. Okay, it is containing a plane of symmetry, and for this reason we know that for molecule have plane of symmetry, the molecule cannot show optical rotation. So for this molecule it has a plane of symmetry. This plane divides the molecule into two equal halves. So for this reason this molecule has no optical activity, because upper carbon is rotating the plane of polarized light towards the right side or left side, whatever, upper side rotation and lower side carbon rotation is equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. So due to this internal compensation, this molecule is optically inactive molecule. Due to the internal compensation of the optical rotation, upper side rotate the plane of polarized light same magnitude like the lower side, but in opposite direction, and for this reason it cancel each other. The optical rotation is net optical rotation is zero because of the cancellation of optical rotation of the upper part and lower part, equal magnitude and opposite direction. So for a molecule to be optically active, it must have chiral carbon or non-superimposable mirror image relationship. But in some cases we can see that the compounds have the chiral carbon, but still the compound is not optically active. Okay, like this one is an example. Okay, so optically active molecules means the molecule that can turn the plane of polarized light either right or left side direction, means that can change the beam of path of the beam of the light, that compound is called optically active compounds. And the mirror image relationships that is formed by the optically active compound means if we place in a mirror, the compounds gives an image, and these are called enantiomers. Okay, so this one is another example of chiral carbon, this is one example of optically active molecule, 2,3-hexadiene. This is optically active molecule. Okay, and this one another example for the diphenyl one, this one the ortho disubstituted diphenyl compound. This one is optically active, and you know this one show a mirror image and non superimposable mirror image. And if we draw the mirror image of this molecule, we can show the mirror image of this molecule, and in this case we can find we can find the mirror image of this molecule as and NO2COOH. So this one is the mirror image of this ortho disubstituted diphenyl compound. Okay, so these are called enantiomers. Enantiomers of ortho disubstituted diphenyl compound. This one is an optically active molecule. Okay, ortho disubstituted diphenyl compound, optically active molecule. It can forms enantiomers, means this is the mirror image. This one is the mirror image of this molecule, mirror image of the molecule, and these two are called enantiomers. So in organic chemistry, you can find the some molecules that have the property of turning the plane of polarized light either right or left is called optically active compound. And optical activity of the molecule, compound must have a chiral carbon, or compound must show non superimposable mirror image relationship with its image. Means molecule and its image should be non superimposable in its mirror image relationship. That time compound can have the optical property, means compound can show the optical isomerism. And these are the examples of some optically active molecules, enantiomers and optical activity. Okay, and if you say that which instrument is used for the measuring the optical activity of the organic molecule, polarimeter is used for measuring the optical activity of the molecules. And you have to know some terms like monochromatic light. White light is polychromatic in nature. Here we need monochromatic light. What is plane of polarized light? You have to remember. Okay, what is plane of polarized light? When light vibrates only in one plane, we call the light as the plane of polarized light. Okay, and the working of the polarimeter, and what are the formula for the specific rotation of an organic molecule, that part I would discuss in some other videos. Now right now in this lecture we just discuss about the optical isomerism, means when organic molecule can show optical isomerism, D and L isomerism, and optical activity of the organic molecule, enantiomers. These are the main topic of discussion. And remember one point, that chiral carbon present means molecule is optically active. No. Molecule can be optically inactive. If you talk about the racemic mixture is optically inactive, but each racemic mixture is a 50% mixture of D isomer and L isomer, or plus isomer and minus isomer. So both the mixture components are optically active, but overall in the mixture no optical rotation is present. The individual enantiomers are optically active, but as the enantiomers present in 50:50 ratio, that time what happens, due to the external compensation, one plus isomer can rotate the plane of polarized light in same magnitude that the turning by the minus isomer of the minus enantiomers, so in opposite direction. Okay, so plus isomer and minus isomer turns the plane of polarized light equal magnitude and opposite direction, and due to this external compensation, racemic mixture has no optical rotation. So for a molecule to be optically active, there must be chiral carbon atom. But chiral carbon atom is not the not all, means you cannot say chiral carbon atom present means molecule is optically active. Other conditions like superimposable or not, there are other chiral carbon atom present or not, that molecule can the optical rotation of one chiral carbon is cancelled by the optical rotation of other chiral carbon, you have to know. So this is the discussion about the enantiomer, optical activity of the organic molecules and the optical isomerisms. So this is the discussions. If you find this discussion is useful for you, then can like these discussions. And if you have any question regarding the optical isomerism, optically active compound or enantiomer, etc., then you can write in the comment section below. And if you find this channel is useful for you, then you must subscribe this channel. Or sorry, I cannot say that must subscribe this channel. You can subscribe this channel. It is not any, I am not applying any force to you that subscribe this channel, subscribe this channel. It's just, you know, I have to say in the ending of each video that subscribe this channel if you find this channel useful. So that's it. And for this channel, you can find this playlist in the that I made in this channel. And from the playlist, you can watch the other videos regarding organic chemistry or other parts of the chemistry. So I think you can watch the videos from this playlist. So thank you for watching this discussion.